Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So, I actually picked the topic of the week, and it was, the topic is loneliness, and how do you deal with loneliness? And I actually got my topic from a very interesting person who you're going to meet here in a minute. I remember first of all, loneliness is not necessarily just an LGBT issue. It's an issue that everyone deals with. But I do think when you are LGBT or you're in the closet, loneliness is kind of exacerbated. It really is, because you're living a lie and you can't share it with anybody because you're closeted. I still remember before I was in my relationship, when I was single and in the closet, I was pretty lonely. I dreaded the weekends because I was off and I didn't have anything to do. And so anyway, I'd like to introduce someone. He has been a clinical counselor for 36 years, and he's also been my significant other, now my husband, for almost a year, but we've been together for 26 years, 25 years. Come on. This is him.
Hello, Out Late the Great.
So anyway, you're the one that actually gave me the idea for this, because you said you've had a lot of clients lately that have been lonely, and how do you deal with them?
Well, thank you for having me today. This is a very common condition that is seen, you know, in clinical practices, and just kind of getting prepared to do this for today, I did a little research on my own. And one of the things I was really surprised to learn was how prevalent loneliness is, mostly in our country. Our country reports more loneliness in people than any other country on the planet. Up to about 20% of people in our country report loneliness, and that's about 60 million people altogether, you know, right now. You know, and I think there's a difference between, you know, feeling lonely and being socially isolated. But that's a real trigger, being socially isolated, for loneliness, because it can lead to depression and it can also lead to suicide in so many people. We know that it affects health, it affects the immune system, and that can affect people also in terms of overall health and wellness. One of the things that I find is that it's very treatable, that people that make themselves available to therapy and come in, talk therapy, can do very well with this in terms of making better connections with other people, getting out of themselves, and most importantly, challenging and revising maybe some of their negative self-talk that will keep them isolated and keep them lonely. And I've experienced loneliness in my own life, and especially in those times before we met 26 years ago, when I was just alone and by myself and maybe feeling a little bit socially isolated. But that has changed pretty significantly, and those lonely days are just a distant memory for me now.
Me too.
Yeah. So I hope you will take this for what it's worth and give it some thought.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for being our surprise guest this Friday. And what are we going to do this weekend? We're going to go see the Browns' first home opener at the stadium. So that should be fun. But it's supposed to rain, so we'll see. So anyway, guys, that's all. Take care, love you, and I will talk to you next week. Bye-bye.
See ya.